and welcome to Guitar Skills. Today we're having a look at open seventh chords. So after major and minor chords, these are the most common chords that you'll come up against if you're learning songs or if you just want to move your guitar playing on to the next step. Seventh chords have a slightly kind of unresolved sound. So if I play an E7 chord, in the middle is this kind of odd sounding interval which gives the chord a kind of bluesy sound. So they're commonly used in blues music, but they're used in pretty much every type of music as well. And the other way these chords are described is an unresolved sound. So if I play an A chord, and then an E chord, and then E7, it kind of really wants to resolve back to the A chord, back to the first chord a lot more. So we're going to show you the fingerings for all the different seventh chords in the open position, and we'll show you some alternate fingerings as well. Some of the chords you can play in more than one way, and we'll just explain a bit about that as we go along as well. Lots of people get mixed up about how come you can play the same chord with different fingerings and different shapes. We're also going to show you some minor seventh chords, and then we'll show you lots of examples and ways to help you change between the chords as well, so you've got some things to play using these seventh chords. As always, with all the lessons, stop, rewind and practice any sections that you need to. Try not to watch the video all the way through and learn 10 chords in half an hour. Take one or two chords and spend as long as you need to learning those shapes, whether it's a couple of hours, a couple of days, a couple of weeks, however long that takes you, and mix it with everything else that you've learned previously, so you're building on everything and you remember things a lot more easily. Otherwise, let's start by showing you the fingering for an open E7 chord. My first finger is just behind the first fret on the G string, and my middle finger is just behind the second fret on the A string. And I can play all the strings for this chord from the open E. As with all the open chords, keep these fingers really curled, which encourages them to go on the fingertips very much. That means they're not going to be touching the strings next to it. Or with the first finger, it's really easy for the first finger just to kind of lie flat a bit, catch the top open strings. So as with any new chord that you're learning, if you play one string at a time, you can check all the strings are ringing. Commonly, if you're starting out, you'll get a bit of this happening, and that should be the D string. Follow it all the way along, that should be an open string. So my middle finger just needs to come a little bit more upright to let the D string ring open. And it's a really small difference between that, where the string doesn't ring, and then moving my finger up a small amount and letting the string ring open. So really essential, keep the fingers a little bit curled so they go on the fingertips. The other way this chord is commonly shown is to play an open E chord with all three fingers, and then lift up your ring finger, and then you've got E7. So you can start by adding in a bit of strumming, moving between an open E chord and E7. If you strum four beats on each chord, you could try 1, 2, 3, and 4, E7, 2, 3, and 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and E7 again. So we're going to give you a quick crash course in some theory and seventh chords. To make an E7 chord, we add the seventh note from the major scale. The major scale of E, you play open string E, the second fret, the fourth fret, all along the bottom string. Same fingering on the A string, open string, second fret, fourth fret, and then the first fret on the D string, and then the second fret on the D string. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 notes all together in that scale. To play an E7 chord, it's actually a flat 7. So instead of the D sharp on the first fret, that actually goes one note lower, which goes down to the open string, which goes down to a D, or D natural. So for the E7, all we have to do is add that D somehow, which just means we lift the ring finger. You might also see these chords called a dominant 7, and that distinguishes it from adding a major 7th. You can get major 7th chords where you add in the D sharp, but we're just going to look at dominant 7th chords where we add in the flat 7th.